Hello and welcome to the pre-market update from Nirmal Bang. I am Hiral Dadia. Clearly, yes, there is some bit of positivity that's coming in from the global markets. You have stocks in Asia Pacific which are trading pretty much mixed, especially South Korean markets are on the positive end, whereas there is some bit of pressure coming in on the Japanese markets. The clear thing we need to pick up today is the red flag that IMF has given out with regards to the risk of severe global recession that the global economies could be facing. Overall, if you go to see in overnight trade, US stock futures have slipped slightly, so there is a possibility that Dow futures could open up gap down to the tune of around almost 85 points. Whereas in yesterday's session, we saw Dow ended with gains of almost 560 points. S&P 500 as well as Nasdaq saw significant gains as well. European markets have also closed higher, but the major help that's coming in over there is because some countries, including Italy and Spain, have now started to look to lift some of the restrictions, and that's something which is giving them a positive fillip. Overall, the yield also on the benchmark 10-year treasury note has been pretty much flat at around 0.74%. Interestingly, global oil producers are now expected to cut the overall output by nearly 20% with regards to where the world supply is concerned, and that's something which actually is giving support today. Yesterday's session, oil prices have shed more than 10%, whereas in Asian hours right now, Brent futures are up around 2%, US crude futures, that's WTI, which is trading with gains of almost around 3.5%. So keep your eyes on crude as well. There could be a lot of strategies that could be coming in from the commodity space. On the precious metal front, gold continues to rally to almost a 7-year peak. In fact, gains of almost around 0.8% that have come in on spot gold. You have now palladium, platinum as well as silver. All these three precious metals have also started to play the catch-up rally with the safe haven. So you could see some bit of a momentum build-up that could be coming in on these metals. On the markets front, SGX Nifty, yes, it is indicating a pretty flattish start to trade today. However, the levels that we are looking at is somewhere above 9,200 as per SGX Nifty. In fact, if you see the FII, DII data as well in the cash market, both have remained sellers, and this is the provisional data that we have been picking up. Markets overall, if you go to see, we have logged losses in terms of where the last session goes. So that's something that we need to put our eyes on as well, because now that, you know, the 21-day lockdown has been extended to the 3rd of May, that's something that could be giving us marginal jitters as well, because Nifty has slipped below that 9,000 mark. Investors have gone ahead and locked profits because we'd almost seen a rally of 13% that did come in on Nifty 50. So there is that profit booking factor that did come in. In fact, if you talk about the Sensex as well, that also slipped. The Nifty has lost almost around 120 points in the previous session. So today's session, again, you could expect to see a flattish open, and there is a possibility that we could witness sideways move during the day as well. We are seeing strong resistance at 9,110 to 9,240 levels. Whereas on the flip side, 8,910 level may act as a support level. If we see any move below that 8,910 level, there is a possibility that we could extend the rally towards 8,780 and 8,640 on the downside. So overall, the view still remains cautious. It is a pretty much stock-specific market, and the thing is that we will have to take calls with strict stop losses. On Bank Nifty front as well, we are seeing immediate support that's coming in around that 19,200 level on the downside. But if we close below that 19,200 level on Bank Nifty, we could expect a fall to levels of almost 18,870 on the first one number and 18,570, that's the second level. However, there is that immediate resistance that we are expected to face at 19,850 and 20,160 on the upside. So these are clear levels that we should be watching out for on the Bank Nifty front. Whereas if you see again in terms of where the F&O activity is concerned, that's something that is going to be crucial as well, because Nifty April futures have ended at a premium versus a discount, and we've seen the April futures shed almost 3% in open interest, whereas on the Bank Nifty front, the April futures have shed almost 4% in open interest. The Nifty put call ratio is at around 1.39 versus a 1.48, and the maximum open interest on the call side is at 9,000, whereas on the put side is at around levels of 8,000. So these are key levels, and this is the broad range that we should be watching out for as well. Because clearly, if you see liquidation, we are seeing it at levels of around 9,100, 9,000 and 8,900 strike. And this is actually indicating that volatility is expected to remain in the near term as well. So yes, derivative data is indicating volatility. Whereas if you talk about the FI activity as well, they have remained net sellers in the cash market, whereas they continue to remain net sellers in the index futures as well. So that's a data point that we continue to look at. Again, a flattish opening and volatility is expected to remain high during the day. In fact, that's all that we have in the pre-market morning update from Nirmal Bang. You could subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram to get more updates. Thank you.